Alright. What up?
Hi.
I was going to introduce this woman. First of all, my name is Debo, and welcome to the African Inspired Dreams Audio Empowerment Series. They say beauty is common, but yo, the one that's sitting across me, like, yo, she does it effortlessly. So, if I introduce her, I don't think I'm going to do you justice. So please introduce yourself to our viewers, or listeners, in fact.
Sure. First of all, thank you for having me on this platform. My name is Lorraine Charlotte Bagoya, but everyone calls me Locke. And I am a cultural producer based in Harare, Zimbabwe. And I'm the community manager for Zimbabwe's first creative hub, Motor Republic.
Motor Republic. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Okay, so the reason why I'm doing these series is to empower females. And I believe, like, I've known you for about a year now. And
right.
You're one of the few women in Zim who are actually, like, in the forefront of making sure, how can I put this, things get done in terms of creativity. And you're an innovator, basically. So tell me about who you are as an entrepreneur and what gave you that spirit to actually be in this crazy industry.
Wow, thank you for those amazing words. But I would classify myself as an entrepreneur.
Really?
Essentially, I work for and with an organization called Magumba, mm-hmm. and they're a cultural activist organization that's been around for almost 10 years now. Mm-hmm. And so they gave me an opportunity to actually be active in the creative space. So that's something that I've always been grateful for, and they've given me a platform to actually just amplify a passion and a voice in actually advancing and putting creative activity on the map here in Zimbabwe. And I guess I forgot your question.
What I was saying was, describe yourself as a creative entrepreneur, but she corrected me and told me that she is not a creative entrepreneur.
Yes, more of a producer,
than
entrepreneur. They say that those that can't play coach, and that's pretty much what I do.
You're doing a pretty good job.
Yeah.
So you're a boss lady. Basically.
Well, I am in charge of running the creative hub itself. So in terms of executing the vision and making sure that we are providing as many platforms as we can to contribute to the development of creative entrepreneurs and the industry, I am at the realm of that.
You're doing a really amazing job.
Thank you.
Yeah. Describe a busy day, like a typical Monday.
I love Mondays. So
really?
Yeah. I get most of my work done on a Monday. Well, that's because I do nothing on the weekends. I love my job, so I get very excited about getting to work on the many projects that we do have.
Uh-huh.
So a basic Monday is pretty much planning the week, setting the tone for it, obviously. So there's a lot of meetings. Mondays was also busy because I have a lot of people that stop by.
And then now
a lot of people that do stop by with questions and queries, which is always good and encouraged, because it just means that they're interested in what we're doing here. So pretty much coming in, we listen to some motivational talks in the morning, which is great. And we just get to work. So
that's a thing that you guys do here. Like, you put
well, it's something that I do with one of my colleagues.
Yes.
So we do that every morning.
Who are you listening to right now?
Huh?
Who motivates you? Like,
it's a lot of TD Jakes.
Nice.
And a guy named Eric Thomas.
Yeah.
And there's so many of them on YouTube.
Yeah.
It's just this really corny, sappy background using words. And so we really get a buzz off of doing that.
Are you married? Are you in a relationship?
No, I'm not. Not married. Not in a relationship.
So you don't have to find that challenge where you have to balance work and personal life. But family, also having your mom and whatever, that is balancing the personal
life. Yeah, work-life balance. I came from a space where I just never really believed in work-life balance because it's just very difficult to just manage priorities generally. But because I'm passionate about my self-development and passionate about work, everything contributes to each other. So I find balance in being better at doing my job and being better at being good to myself. And so that just makes everything
balance out.
Because everything that I do contributes to making sure everything is dope.
Living your best life and
Exactly.
I like that.
That actually just makes everything.
How do you stay motivated? Because I've seen you under pressure. I've seen you under pressure during the events and whatnot. And I always wonder, like, no matter what you're going through, and you have like a thousand things that you're thinking, and then like things, shit needs to get done, but then you always have someone, hey, look, can I take a selfie? Hey, look, can I, whatever. But how do you find that balance of keeping your stress levels, especially when you're dealing with public events and people a lot? You do it with a lot of people. How do you find that balance not to lash out? Because a lot of people can't handle pressure, and then they end up being bitchy.
Well, maybe you just haven't seen me be bitchy.
I've seen you in the corner of my eye. Like,
I think the most important thing is just to just always be present and just in every moment, and just remember that the main thing is the main thing. So especially like when you're running around during events, everyone has an important question, and it's my job to answer to it. It's my job to put out the fire. It's my job to make sure that the event is running. So always being mindful of the fact that that needs to get done. And that's my job to make sure it happens. Make sure that it actually just guarantees that I'm always putting that best foot forward and not getting overwhelmed with the situation. Because at the end of the day, the event has to go on. At the end of the day, people have questions that need to be answered. And I gain nothing from
being
flustered and being a bitch. Exactly. It does not help any situation. So
I like that.
And that came with practice. So,
like, so
it wasn't always like that.
I'm actually thinking about
it. Wasn't always like that, but it's stuff that you pick up along the way.
Are you collaborating in terms of, I know you don't call yourself a creative entrepreneur, but then you work with a lot of female creatives. So the first question is, who do you look up to locally and internationally as in someone who's doing something in business creatively? And first answer that one.
Sure. I look up to, like, locally, someone who's been very big is Titi Mutendi. She is a creative entrepreneur herself. She runs Dante Media. And so they've done a number of publications, which include Jewel Magazine, and they're the publishers behind the Edgar's monthly publications. And now she's moved into actually making toys. So she's like a serial entrepreneur. And I definitely appreciate the drive and the vision. And just, you know, just the hustle that comes with actually trying to do, to set up a business, especially in the creative industries in Zimbabwe. So she's been very successful in doing that. And then I'm just inspired by everyone that comes through these doors every day. They do something that I am not able to do, something I admire, something I'm very passionate about, contributing to making sure that it's valid and it exists. So, so it ranges from Oprah to you.
She actually looks up to me.
So I mean, everyone who just, you know, is pursuing their dreams, in whichever way they know how and however they can, is someone that I'm always feeding off of.
This is one question that I try to avoid asking females, but then there's something that females who are especially in business always is a problem that they face. So basically, how do you deal with men who can't, who, you're an attractive lady. The first thing someone's actually going to do is try to flirt with you. How do you, like, separate that and say, no, either this is going to be just business or nothing at all, but then still, what if you need that person to get somewhere, but then that person is blocking you in terms of, okay, just because he sees a female, he doesn't respect your brains, he doesn't treat you the way he would treat a male.
Right.
So I'm sure you faced it.
I have faced that, not as often as I know a lot of other people have.
Yeah.
And I think there's an element there of just, you know, being able to play the cards that you're dealt, essentially, yeah, with a twist. So, being attractive definitely does...
blessing and the curse.
And then it opens doors, but it's not what keeps you in the room, essentially.
Yeah, that's true.
So you really just have to be smart and conscious,
yeah,
and confident with how you navigate, because that's one of the things that's actually never... I don't want to say never going to change, but yeah, it's definitely going to be around for a while, that people are just definitely going to take advantage of their power and even waste your time.
That is true.
Waste your time generally, and I guess you just have to, you know, sometimes you have to take the loss and charge it to the game.
Yeah.
We all have choices, and exactly, you have to navigate in ways that actually you're comfortable with.
Yeah.
So, I mean, just know your values and know your standards and commit to them, and that is always a good way to stay true to yourself and in your business at the end of the day.
And what she said, like, young girls that are listening, being beautiful gets you into the door. It does not keep you there. So please practice your craft and just let your work speak for itself.
Yeah, just
please.
Be good. And I know, and then it doesn't take someone with a mind long enough to know that you know what you're talking about.
Exactly.
You care about what you're doing, and then they know not to mess with that.
Exactly.
Essentially.
Like, I'm intimidated by this woman. Like, I do not come with, like, with bullshit. Like, you need to step correctly. So, give me, for young women and teenagers, I'm in my late 20s, and I wish that I had someone as a kid growing up to guide me or direct me in the right direction. If you don't have that as a female, what advice can you give, like, a young girl who's trying to be you? Like, what would you say to yourself?
First, I'd say aim higher.
Aim higher.
Not because there's anything wrong with me. I don't think that I'm great or good, but because you can, you know, you could always be better. You definitely can always be better.
Yeah.
And I would say that, because I grew up, I didn't have people I looked up to, essentially, who were doing the same thing that I'm doing now. I don't know a lot. I do not know a lot of people that are doing the same thing I'm doing now. But I looked around and I looked everywhere at women who were just doing amazing work and being innovative. And I read widely and wildly, something one of my friends Veneca always says, about them. And then there's always something to learn from everyone.
Right.
So whether, you know, a person is the female president, or, you know, as a doctor, may not be in the career field, in the same career field, but there's always something that they have done that I am able to do, that I admire, and I think I can adopt to create the vision I see for myself. So you can create your own world, just feeding off of everything that's around you,
right,
and create your own inspiration, essentially.
Three words to describe you.
Man.
Off the top of your head, don't even think about it.
I really feel like I've answered this question so many times.
Really? So four.
And I've said different things all the time. I'm passionate. I'm smart.
Yes.
And I'm silly. Those are three things I definitely am most of the time, all the time.
You call yourself the king.
Yeah.
Why?
Why not?
Why? Oh, that's what. You see.
Why not? I started doing that because Beyonce, and it just stuck. Like I said, I believe in creating your own space, creating your own world, creating your own whatever that you are at, you know, the head of, and you rule.
Yes.
The space that you're in. Yeah. So then that makes me a king, and I don't feel like a gender is subscribed to that.
Nice. I like that. All right. You told me how you feed yourself, like, mentally.
Mm-hmm.
Physically, how do you feed yourself? And spiritually, that's very important. How do you feed yourself?
Physically, all I've currently, like this year, I really started off just eating well and clean.
Yeah.
So lots of vegetables and lots of fruits and a lot of water. And that's actually just a very big change from how I've lived my life for the past 30 years. But I'm really enjoying it. Yeah. And I feel good about myself. So that is something. Feeding my spirit and my soul. I'm on a very deep self-love journey and self-development journey.
Yeah.
So I literally just tell myself I'm awesome and I love myself every day.
Exactly.
And loving myself means going to the gym. It means paying attention to the energy around me. It means paying, you know, reading the right things, being around the right people that actually feed and serve my life goals. So I really hope it's something that I can actually keep up for the rest of my life because it feels pretty amazing.
Cool. Mm-hmm. So this woman, I came in on a Monday morning unannounced because I had canceled the previous meetup and I knew that if I texted, she was going to tell me not so nice words. But then she gave me her time and I promised her that this audio appointment would only be 15 minutes. Mm-hmm. But then throughout the year, she'll be like, I'm going to be all up in your face.
That's fine.
Giving you, like, I have a passion for a lot of females and don't have a lot of people to look up to. And I keep on saying you're one of the many few. So thank you so much for like even giving me your time, because time is very important. We all know that. Yes. So
thank you. Now this was a pleasure. All right, so I hope that it serves its purpose.
It does. It does. All right. So Steve-O signing out with the king.
All right.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you.